This week's reading, I'm so excited. I'm so excited to read this because Mr. Austria loves dogs, right? I love dogs. Who doesn't love dogs, right? Dogs are awesome. We call man's best friends, right? So today we're going to learn about different breeds of dogs, all right? Different breeds of dogs. So we see them here. They see the pictures in here. So it's a picture of a dog right here and a picture of another dog right here, okay? And I know some of you guys have dogs at home. At the same time, I want to remind you or let you know that after watching this video, you need to read this. So click on the story so you can read it. Practice when you are ready. When you feel that you are ready, record yourself and send your recording to Miss Hapa. Okay. At the same time, right, you also need to do the quiz. There is a quiz after this story. Okay. And the quiz just pretty much just ask you simple questions about the story, about the article. Just trying to make sure, you know, I just want to make sure that you've read it or that you've viewed the video. Okay, so let's get started. All right. By the way, you guys, if you want to follow along as Mr. Austria reads, you're more than welcome to do so. Okay. So I would love that if when I'm reading, you're following along so that you can practice. All right. Let's get started. Breeds of dogs. All right. You see this dog right here. So cute. Okay. Anytime, you know, there's a book that you're about to read, all right, it always helps to look at the table of contents, because the table of contents gives you a preview of what to expect. And when you have a preview of what to expect, you can better understand what you're going to read. All right, so let's get started. All right, so the subtitle, you know, heading here is domestic dogs come in many shapes and sizes and have always provided companionship, help, and affection. Introduction. Did you ever notice how many different kinds of dogs there are? There are big dogs, small dogs, long dogs, short dogs, hairy dogs, and even hairless dogs. There are dogs with big ears, big noses, little noses, long legs, short legs, long tails, and no tails at all. All right. Why are there so many kinds of dogs? The reason is because there are lots of breeds of dogs. Breeds are kinds of dogs that are kept separate from other breeds during mating time. If each breed of dog only mates with his own kind, the puppies will be the same kind of dog too. These dogs are purebred, which means that since their parents are the same, they will be the same too. And male and female bulldog will have pups that are bulldogs. Other dogs are called mixed breed dogs. They are mix of two or more kinds of dogs. Mixed breeds dogs are sometimes called mutts. All right, mutts. I think in Filipino it's called askal, right? Askal. Okay. All right. So, next page. How did different kinds of dogs came to exist? Long ago, there were no dogs. There were only wolves. When people first began living in villages, their garbage became a food source for wolves. Over time, some of the wolves eating human garbage became tamer. These wolves slowly changed to be better at living close to people and began to look and act more like modern dogs. People saw that some of these early dogs were better at running, better at hunting, and others were better at digging. Some people wanted a dog who was even better at one of those tasks. So they started only letting good runners mate with good runners, and they only let good diggers mate with good diggers. You got it. Over many thousands of years, the dogs people kept as pets changed into the breeds of dogs we know today. Of course, the wild wolves stayed wild and are still wild today. There are seven groups, and each one I'm sorry, there are seven groups of dogs, and each one has many breeds. Let's learn about these groups and some of their members. Sporting dogs. Sporting dogs were bred to help hunters. Some sporting dogs help a hunter find the game, the animal that is being hunted. All right, so the game means it's the animal that's being hunted. One, sporting dogs find game that has been shot and bring it back to the hunter. The Pointer is a sporting dog that was bred to sit and point at game. A pointer freezes in place with one front leg up and points with its nose. Ah, oh, that's pretty awesome. Huh? Can you guys do that? Okay. The Labrador Retriever, or Lab, is a popular sporting dog that is also a good family dog. It was first bred to retrieve or bring back birds that haven't been shot if they fell into a pond or lake. Labs have webbed feet to help them swim well. Their waterproof coat keeps them warm in cold winter. They have strong jaws for carrying heavy birds. Hounds. The job of hounds is to chase game on the ground. There are two kinds of hounds. Sight hounds use their eyes to chase game. Scent hounds use their nose to follow the scent or smell of game. Hounds may bark to let a hunter know they have cornered the game, or they may kill the game themselves. The Irish Wolfhound, a sight hound, is one of the tallest dogs in the world. It can be 0.9 meters or 3 feet tall at the shoulder. It was bred to hunt and kill wolves. Its long, strong legs make it faster, make it a fast hunter. The best scenthood is the Bloodhound. It has loose skin on its face and long, flappy ears. Both of these things help stir up smells so that the Bloodhound can find game animals easily. Bloodhounds are also good at finding lost people. So imagine if somebody's lost, you know, why not get a Bloodhound to help you out, right? All right, working dogs. Working dogs are smart and tough. They do jobs like guarding, protecting, rescuing, and pulling sleds and carts. The Newfoundland is a large, sturdy dog, right? It's pronounced Newfoundland. It's not Newfoundland, although it looks like it's Newfoundland. All right, it's pronounced Newfoundland. Newfoundland is a large, sturdy dog. It has a thick, waterproof coat that keeps it warm. Long ago, Newfoundlands were used to pull boats and heavy fishing nets through the water. Today, they are used in Europe to rescue drowning people. Okay. The Samoyeds comes from the coldest parts of Asia. Samoyeds were first used to guard and herd reindeer. Today, they work as sled dogs. Their waterproof coat is extra thick for warmth. Their stocky shape helps keep body heat inside. So these dogs, there's no way. I mean, they're awesome looking, okay? But they're not going to survive in the Philippines, right? Because it's so hot there. They're going to be so hot. They're going to be miserable. Herding dogs. Herding dogs are fast moving and smart. They were bred to control other animals, such as sheep or cattle. Herding dogs control animals by barking, staring, or nipping. You guys know what nipping is, like biting, a little bit bite, like harmless bites. That's when you nip something. Herding dogs are easily trained. They are independent, eager workers. The Welsh Corgi is a sturdy, quick, short-legged dog. It was first bred to drive cattle. Because it is short, it can duck under cows and nip at their ankles. It is able to move quickly to keep from being kicked. The Border Collie was made famous in Babe, a movie about a pig that herded sheep. Babe learned his skill from a Border Collie. Border Collies were bred to herd sheep and cattle, and they still do that work today. They are athletic dogs. They can run very fast. They are good at making sheep and cattle obey them. All right, next one, Terriers. Terriers are usually small or medium in size. Most terriers were bred to find and kill fierce pets like rats. I'm sorry, not pets, pests, right? Like rats, otters, foxes, and badgers. They had to be very brave to hunt these fierce animals. As pets, terriers can be stubborn and hard to train. Stubborn is matigas ang ulo, right? Stubborn. Any of you guys stubborn? The Airedale is the largest terrier. It was originally bred to kill badgers. weasels, and others. It is a natural watchdog, and he also been used as a police dog. Okay. Jack Russell Terriers became very popular because they starred on American television shows such as Frasier and Wishbone. However, this dog is not right for everyone. It needs lots of exercise and activity every day. Otherwise, it will be difficult and destructive. All right, so it needs its nap. Okay, if it doesn't get its nap or rest, it gets irritated and it gets mad. Right, toy dogs. Toy dogs have been bred for their small size. Some toy dogs originally had jobs hunting or killing pests, but most toy dogs were first bred as companions to people. Right, the Papillon is a small, friendly, smart dog with big ears. Papillon is the French word for butterfly. Butterfly. This dog's ears look like butterfly wings. All right. The hairless Chinese crested. Ah, it's so ugly, right? Look at that. It's an ugly dog. The hairless Chinese crested is bald except for puffs of hair on the head and feet. So it looks like it has a hat and socks or gloves, right? It has dark gray skin with pink spots. It needs sunblock lotion in the summer. In the winter, it needs to wear a coat to stay warm. Oh my goodness, this dog is like a person, right? It needs sunblock. Okay, it's kind of ridiculous, all right? Yeah, it is what it is, right? Next one, non-sporting dogs. What are non-sporting dogs? This group of dogs includes many breeds that don't fit into other groups. They were first bred for. Their job now is mostly to be companions to people, all right? The Shar Pei is an unusual looking dog. Its skin is wrinkled and loose, and its mouth is shaped like a hippo's mouth. The Shar Pei was first bred as a Chinese fighting and guard dog. Its loose skin made it possible for dog to twist away in another animal if another animal grabbed it, okay? Dalmatian puppies are born completely white. Their spots develop in the first few weeks of life. Dalmatians were trained to trot beside a horse-drawn coach. If farm animals got in the road, the Dalmatian would move them out of the way. It has also protected the horses from wild dogs. The Dalmatian had to be very strong so it could trot for many miles. All right. So if you're planning in buying a dog, read this one, right? Choosing a dog. Purebred dogs can have health problems. Many people believe that mixed bred dogs are healthier, like the mutts, like the Askles, right? They're actually healthier than purebreds. Mixed breeds come in all sizes and colors. They often have lively personality. Bringing a dog into your family is a big decision, right? You can't just go and grab a dog, right? For you guys, you have to ask your parents. It is very important to keep a dog healthy with regular visits to the vet or veterinarian, right? Veterinarian. So it's like an animal doctor. It is also very important to train the dog to behave well. All right, we're into the last stretch. Now you know more about why there are so many kinds of dogs. Dogs really do come in most every shape and size. They have many kinds of personalities. If you get a dog, be sure to choose one that will get along with your family. A dog can be a good friend for many years. All right, many years meaning what? Average lifespan, 12 years. So that's already many, many years, okay? All right, excellent job. So you guys, what I want you to do, okay, is read this article. And after reading it, all right, obviously you have to watch, you're watching this video. So after reading the article, all right, you can, if you're ready, you can record yourself and send your recording to Ms. Hoppe, okay? Also, do not forget to take a quiz. There's a quiz in Cubbies Online and take that to get credit. Okay, you guys, all right, excellent job. I will see you guys soon. Okay. Bye.